A Merry Christmas to you. I'm Hispanic. I can say it like that. A Merry Christmas to you. Little salt over here, little salt over there. A Merry Christmas to... The hell's going on down there? Oh. Fanboys. On Christmas? Hold on, we gotta... Let me see what I got down here. Hold on. Ah, yeah, that's good. Let me just go ahead and, oh! Hey, Merry Christmas to me, baby! Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, another week has come and gone, and talk about coming so far. Look, we are now in the end of the year of 2023, and what happened not just a few days ago earlier this week? Well, Christmas came! Now, I know you're thinking, Alex, there's no way that fanboys would start combing all over Twitter on the day of Christmas when everybody's getting their gifts and playing the video games that they talk about playing all the time, even though they just sit on Twitter all day instead. No, there's no way they would do that. I mean, during World War I, there was a ceasefire. Why would grown adult men argue about video games on a holiday that they should be spending with their family and loved ones? But of course, as always, fanboys never take a day off, and neither do console wars, because now we've got grown adult men who fight over plastic boxes having a lot of time on their hands in between not being on Twitter to, in fact, turn around and then be on Twitter. So let's take a look and see what happened this week, because you know what? Console warring on Christmas. What a new low we've sunk into. A whole new low. Dante tweets out on Christmas Eve saying, "Be a good parent. Give the gift of hashtag PlayStation this Xmas. No kid deserves be sad having a hashtag Xbox."
Oh, jeez, look at the time.
But it's Christmas,
You're
Daddy.
You're not getting out of this. Put on your work boots and your respirator. I had to pull a lot of strings to get him to hire an 8-year-old.
Don't make me go. I don't want to make him late.
Come on, you're late.
Dante, here we go. Christmas Eve at 9 o'clock at night. And instead of thinking about, oh, I got to put the gifts out for the kids. I got to set everything up. Everybody's going to be ready for tomorrow. It's going to be so great. Honey, get the hot cocoa ready. It's time to relax and watch our favorite Christmas movie together. And spend the time. What? We're gonna talk about fanboys and consoles for Christmas morning, because you want to talk about never give the gift of Xbox for, oh God Christ. The thing is that you are an actual grown fucking adult, and right now the only thing you think about is a console you don't even actually like. Why? What is the purpose of this? You don't like Xbox, right? So why do you always talk about Xbox? It's almost like you're obsessed in like a really weird way, but like not in a good way, almost like a really awkward ex-stalkerish kind of way. Not a good look, my boy. And here's the crazier part about your tweet. We know you failed third grade. That's really it right there, because writing, no kid deserves B. Where's the two? Not the number, because I know you were thinking that as well. Like, why would I put a number in a sentence? You fucking moron. And what if maybe, I don't know, the kid wanted an Xbox? He wouldn't be disappointed then, now would he? You know, it's just begun. It's just begun, because there is always, unfortunately, going to be more of this. So get ready. The General Eric says, to the parents who bought their kids an Xbox, please do me a favor. When you record the kids opening up their gifts in the morning, can you make sure you have your phones tilted sideways? I'd like to see their disappointment in a widescreen format. Thank you.
You're the ghost of Christmas past, right?
That is correct.
Okay, well, I mean, you know that it's February, right?
I am a robot.
Well, you know, obviously. What, are you stupid?
Of course! Of course, this is actually, yes, a Christmas afternoon when I saw this tweet around 2 o'clock. So he's got to be in some really weird time zone to think about this. We are doomed as a society. We're not going to make it. Not even close. There's no way we're going to make it past 2024. On top of that, you're now console warring about, I want to see disappointed kids on Christmas. Dude, this is so fucking pathetic. I've never seen anything like this before. Again, on Christmas Day, talking about like, you got to buy a PlayStation. Look, if you haven't noticed that it's a cult already, I don't know what to fucking tell you. Because if you can't sit here and the only thing you care about, again, is a competing plastic box of video games you don't even actually play, but you're thinking about the disappointment of children because they got an Xbox that they probably wanted, I think the one who has problems here is you. This is coming from me. Now, a day before Christmas Eve, the Wed Dwagon tweets out, what do you want for Christmas? Angel emoji, crying laughing emoji, with a picture of Phil Spencer as a child saying, all I want is for Xbox to exist in 2027.
Hey, get over
here. Oh.
Oh. Well, show him the damn future. Hurry up.
Prepare to see what cannot be seen. Wait. Hell. Shoot.
What's the problem? Do we have a problem?
Let me see your other hand.
No.
Okay.
What's happening?
What the hell?
What's it doing?
It's pissing me off.
No, it's about to. Just chill out.
Well, kick it in.
Hold on.
Get the future going. Just give us a minute, Carl.
The Wed Dwagon, it never ceases to end. An entire year of 2023 where you are daily talking about Xbox for some insane reason. Oh, I know why. You were literally denied them because you used to be an Xbox fanboy. Oh no, is the cat out of the bag? A jilted lover unable to cope with what happened. You know what you are? You're the jealous ex-girlfriend who does nothing but stalk the other person that they broke up with, that they broke up with, because you can't handle it any other way. You see, you're sitting here talking about Xbox again as if they're going to disappear in 2027. I don't know what the future holds, but again, your incessant need to talk about Xbox on a consistent basis, and then to have the gall, the audacity, the testicular fortitude to actually involve your wife in console wars. That's right. No, yeah. That's what you did. Right here. You involved your wife in console wars. You see, your wife was like, honey, who are you talking to all day? Who are you texting all the time? You're like, I'm not texting, honey. I'm owning the Xbox fanboys. And she goes, what the fuck are you talking about? He goes, look, here's this Xbox fanboy that doesn't like the plastic box that I like. So you know what would be really funny? What? If we both took a picture with your phone of looking at this Xbox fanboy's tweet and then we both flicked it off, wouldn't that be great? But the fact that you did this and you thought this was an own, and then the night before Christmas Eve, you're still talking about Xbox and Christmas. There are absolutely new levels of low that I cannot wait to expose in 2024. It's going to be magical. Unleashed on Christmas Day says, kids be like, no to Xbox and yes to PlayStation.
We found this one swimming naked in the fermentarium.
I am the lizard queen.
Give her this and this and then these.
Oh, thank you, doctor.
No, I'm not a doctor.
You know what's crazy about this tweet? Not the fact that it's like incredibly low effort bait. No, that's not what it is. The fact that this tweet has almost 1,000 likes at the time that I screenshot it. 1,000 people were like, yup, that's gonna do it. That's the way. I love PlayStation, a company that doesn't even know I fucking exist. That's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna be so pathetic in my life that on Christmas Day, I'm gonna sit here in console war because a plastic box that I play video games on, actual toys, is something that I put my entire life behind and I make it my actual identity. This is a cult. This is literally what it is. It is a cult. Look, I'm tired, okay? I'm tired. The end of 2023 is coming very quickly, and I really just need one break. It's been 52 weeks of this actual nonsense not stopping every single time, and here we are again on the day of Christmas. We are doing this insanity right now with almost 1,000 people going, yup, I approve. This... I'm gonna go bald. I really am. I'm gonna go bald. My chat calls me bald when I live stream. I'm going to go bald one day. And the day it happens, I don't know what I'm gonna do. CMA 8K DualSense says Microsoft is sending the bots out today. Lots of new, never before seen accounts speeding pro Xbox nonsense. PS5 is better. The games are better. It looks better. It performs better. PlayStation has never ever gone a year without games. This was posted on Christmas Day at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Dear Santa, you are a bitch nigga.
Wait, hold on.
Dear Santa, you are a bitch ass nigga.
Yes, Microsoft is gonna go ahead and create an entire Twitter bot farm and then to start pushing out pro Xbox propaganda, because that's where the $1 trillion is gonna go on Twitter bots, because on Christmas Day you're arguing about a console on Twitter. What is wrong with you people? And then to sit here and your only thing to post is PlayStation better. Look, I don't know how far you're able to put Jim Ryan's cock down your throat, but literally you are gagging on the balls, my friend. You're putting someone like Rebecca Linares to shame. That's an oldie but a goodie. I bet you just thought about that one. Like, poof, that's a core memory unlocked for you, huh? But sitting here talking about video games, clearly you don't have any games to play on your PlayStation because you're on Twitter on Christmas talking about PlayStation having games. Yet, you're not playing any games, so who has video games? Who? Or whom? Whom would be the right... Whom? Who? Look, I'm losing my mind during this. I'm surprised I haven't got an aneurysm yet. Just the actual clot moving to the back of my brain and exploding a new vessel. And I haven't even gotten to, of course, the fact that you again, like every other one of your ilk, have failed third grade. Speeding pro Xbox nonsense. You mean spreading pro Xbox nonsense. Like I spread your dad's hole on a daily basis. Wide. He calls me daddy. JTech TV says, did you get an Xbox or coal? This was also posted on Christmas Day.
Wow, the March 8th newspaper.
Cool, a book of carpet samples.
Come on, new bike. Oh, a soiled wig.
You know, sometimes I think to myself, there's got to be an end of this one day. There's no way this is going to be, like, sustainable. There's going to be a time when fanboys are just going to stop, right? And maybe I'll have to change content at some point. Nope! Here we got JTech TV, of all people. The person who really shouldn't have a Twitter account, honestly, after everything that he's done. Ooh, look that one up. You'll be surprised if you don't know. But of course, here we have JTech TV being like, did you get Cole or an Xbox? They're both the same. Look, my guy, my clown, that's what you are. You are an actual clown. Listen, the lisp never lies for you, my boy. The fact that your content is now so incredibly dry, I don't even know if what you have is actually considered content. You actually went out and bought yourself an Xbox to stream yourself playing on Xbox. Boy. I don't think you clearly understand what you're actually doing, and this really isn't the W you think it is. Going around and buying the console that you do not like of the brand you don't like to then play it live on stream so that you think people will watch you when in fact you are failing at that as well. I don't... What is... Oh, God, dude. What? Oh, boy. Oh, man. Oh, 2024 can't come soon enough. And I'm backed up. Immensely. Kieran, the Game Awards fan, says, Merry Christmas to everyone except those that bought their kids Xboxes. You monsters.
No way, Shake, wait.
I am in training.
Kind of fruity when you...
Oh, Kieran, look, I don't understand how you're still here talking about anything ever again or even tweeting. You're the same guy that wants to eat his own cum. How? Maybe don't tweet anymore. Maybe close your Twitter account. Maybe get something new. Look, you can't even use the protein excuse because there isn't enough protein in cum to actually make it viable to eat. So, my boy, what are we doing here on Christmas Eve talking about calling parents monsters for getting them a console for their kids that their kids probably actually wanted in the first place. Again, console warring on a holiday about a plastic box. The guy who eats his own nut on a daily basis. 200 likes. 200 people. 200 people. If it was like one or two, you would have a point. This is 200 people being like, yes, let's go. Those people are monsters for buying their kids a console that they probably wanted for Christmas, because it's not the blue one, it's the green one instead, because you need to be part of the blue team and not the green team. I really think that this is now devolving into almost a political style of commentary with the console war. It's gotten that bad where we're talking about like us versus them, or this team and that team, or you guys are monsters for liking this plastic box that I don't like. But is it gonna get worse? Abso-fucking-lutely. Parvum Principi says the best way to ruin Christmas is by giving your kid an Xbox.
When I started this clown thing, I thought it would be nothing but glory. You know, the glory of being a clown. I tell you, it's hard, tiring work. But when I see the smiles on their little faces, I just know they're getting ready to jab me with something.
Double the clown, double the frown. Look, I gotta sit here and say, what happened to you in your childhood? Did your dad shit in your cereal? Were you like, did something happen to you where the only thing you can think about on Christmas Eve is the fact that you are now talking about a console and saying that parents are bad for buying their kids Xboxes? You know, there's bait, and then there's just like fucking insanity. Because you've been on this channel before. You've talked about things like this before. So it's not like you're baiting anybody. You literally believe this. Your entire Twitter page is PlayStation propaganda. Through and through. I've never seen anything so in actual life, seeing it in live actually happening. But again, now here we go. The best way to ruin Christmas is to give your kid an Xbox. No, the best way to ruin Christmas is when you were conceived. That's how a Christmas present was ruined by your family. When your mom should have swallowed instead. Sean K. the King says that disappointment when he sees that Xbox. He wanted that PS5. Crying laughing emoji. Baby, 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 we got a big one, my boys. 30,000 likes on this one. You know it, you love it. If I was lying, I'd be flying. My feet are stuck on the ground, my boys. 30,000 likes about console wars on Christmas. Christmas! Console wars! Video games! What is happening here? You see, the crazy thing about this tweet, Sean, is that this video right here is actually old. That's right, it didn't happen this year. It's an old meme that happened a couple of years ago. And I'm pretty sure this was also staged as well. A lot of the stuff that happens on Christmas Day is actually staged too, so I wouldn't take it too seriously. However, though, the only thing not being taken seriously is the fact that you have 30,000 people that were in agreement with like, oh yes, the Xbox is pure disappointment on the holidays. That's my dog barking in the background. She's ready to go outside. But you see, Sean, I'm gonna go ahead and hit you where it hurts, my boy, because the only thing that's a disappointment to you right now is, in fact, your YouTube channel. Over 100,000 subs, barely breaking a few hundred views. I can see why you're angry about a plastic box on Christmas Day. I can see why you are just continually just trying to go ahead and fan the console war flames. This is the only kind of engagement you actually get on Twitter, because it's definitely not happening on your YouTube channel. It's about that time you go ahead and close that bad boy down. Start something new. Maybe learn to edit, because clearly, what you're doing right now, my boy, even my dog agrees, it's not worth it. Big Boss 69 says, after 25 years of loyalty, I finally sold my PS5 and switched to Xbox Series S, and I have no regrets. The Xbox is superior in every way. Performance, games, features, and value. PlayStation is dead to me. Hashtag Xbox forever.
Smell it. That smell. The kind of smelly smell. The smelly smell that smells. Smelly.
Popo, I gotta tell you this. That, my friend, is some really good bait. I knew it was bait the second I saw it, because I've seen you around that old Twitter spaces, too. Don't think I'm not watching. But see, the thing is, I knew it was bait. Everybody else I know knew it was bait, because that's clearly a bait post. But you see, the funny thing is, you kind of exposed the community of PlayStation fanboys, because they didn't think it was bait. No, they took it for real. In fact, you were hit so hard in the replies, that's not a good ratio. Even though most people knew it was bait, you were still getting hit quite hard with 600 replies plus and only 900 likes. So somebody was a little bit upsetty spaghetti. You know what I mean? And I'm just going ahead and posting those right here because, man, it's really funny to watch the fact that PlayStation fanboys are in fact acting like an actual cult on a consistent basis, yet here we are all the time saying, oh, why do you always pick on the PlayStation fanboys? Because when a bait post happens, look at how everyone responds to this. Even the guy who posts his trophies on his Twitter account, and if you would go to look for it for 2 seconds, you'd be like, oh, it's a bait post. You still took it! You took the bait and you're replying! Oh my god. I don't even know what to do anymore. I don't even know how, you know what? We gotta transform this, ladies and gentlemen. This has to get transformed in 2024. We're gonna make some changes, some good ones. So ladies and gentlemen, that is gonna be it for hopefully this year. We have now done 52 episodes of Fanboys for the year of 2023. And I gotta say, the one thing, like I say every single week, we now have people who are grown adults who spend a little bit of money on a console thinking that they now own part of that company or represent that company in some weird way, even though they just bought a toy or a plastic box. Could you actually imagine that kind of behavior? I'm sure having conversations with them in real life has got to be just riveting and exciting, don't you think? But you see, again, we have these people defending a corporation, getting so upset about things that they have to now talk about it on Christmas Day or Christmas Eve or involve their wife and family or do all of the kinds of things or even buy the competing console to try and make content for themselves, completely fail out of the third grade, expose how horribly literate they are, and then move on from there on a weekly basis. So I don't think this is going to end anytime soon. But here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen. If you like this kind of video, thank you. If you didn't like it, fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe. We are almost at the very tip of hitting 60,000 subscribers. That's right, we're over 200 subs away from that. So I'm not asking you to subscribe to hit that number. No, I'm asking you to subscribe if you like this kind of content. If you want to see more fanboy videos, more gaming news, more PC port reviews, more Steam Deck videos, more live streams on Saturdays at 8:45 p.m. Eastern, where I get insulted by my own chat for 4.5 hours with them using TTS. Yes, it's really insane. And if you want access to the Discord and also emotes during those live streams, consider becoming a YouTube member. It's as low as a buck. And if you don't want to spend that dollar, don't sweat it. Just come on down to live stream and hang out. Trust me, you're going to have a great time, I promise. And with all that being said, y'all, I hope you had a wonderful holiday. I hope you're totally safe in the new year. Please do not drink and drive. Please go ahead and take care of yourselves first and foremost. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one, and I'll see you next year.